But if you're listening in, it means the Houston Texans have a brand new coach. It is not Josh McCown. It is not Jonathan Gannon. It is not Brian Flores. The answer is Lovie Smith. The Texans defensive coordinator is now the head honcho in charge. News came down late last night. Texans were interested in interviewing Lovie Smith out of the blue. All of a sudden, less than 24 hours later, it's been reported by multiple national people, including the NFL Network and ESPN, that Lovie Smith is now the next head coach of the Houston Texans. How did we get here? Why are we here? What does this all mean? We'll talk about it between now and 7 o'clock. But, Cody, I just heard you on with Joel and Jeremy during crosstalk at the end of their show. I mean, needless to say, you talk about a hire coming out of left field. That's hiring Lovie Smith this late into the hiring process.
Man, this is the second offseason in a row that the Houston Texans have had to make a significant pivot with their offseason. A very significant pivot with their offseason. I believe with every fiber in my being that Josh McCown was going to be the head coach of this football team. And the Houston Texans looked around, had conversations, maybe read some headlines, listened to some people from outside the building, and decided it would be a public relations nightmare if Josh McCown is our announced head coach in the 2022 offseason. So we have to pivot. They pivoted very fast to Lovie Smith, and now Lovie Smith is going to be the head coach, and it's very much a careful-what-you-wish-for scenario. If you didn't want McCown, I think there were some better options out there, but they end up with Lovie Smith as they had to pivot and apparently pivot in a hurry.
They fired David Culley after 1 year. They paid him $22 million to leave, and then they hired his defensive coordinator slash associate head coach. It's embarrassing. It really is. First of all, anybody who said they saw this coming is lying. This was a total pivot by the Texans. I know there were some reports last night, Jake, that said, Lovie Smith has been in consideration throughout this entire process. That's just not true. But, man, if you root for the Houston Texans, whether you're a diehard who lives and dies by what happens to this team, or if you're just a casual fan who catches a couple of games a year and hopes they win, I'm sorry. You deserve better than what's gone on around here the last few years. And if you're trying to convince yourself that this is a good hire or a good thing for the Houston Texans, then you're buying in to Jack and Nick, because this is unacceptable. There's not another fan base in the NFL that would be okay with Lovie Smith being their next head coach. We talked about it with Josh McCown. What was one of the biggest reasons we were criticizing the Texans for considering Josh McCown? Of course, it was the lack of experience thing, but the other issue was no other team in the NFL was interviewing this guy to be their head coach, right? Nobody else wanted Josh McCown. Nobody else even considered Josh McCown. That's one of the reasons why we were so critical of the Texans interviewing that guy multiple times. Nobody wanted Lovie Smith either. Nobody requested to interview Lovie Smith. Nobody's wanted that dude as an NFL head coach for years. Texans fans were mad last year that this guy was going to be the defensive coordinator for this team. And now people all of a sudden are talking themselves into this guy being the head coach and they're happy about it. You guys deserve better, man. Y'all know I'm not like a diehard fan of this franchise, but I care about the people of this city and I want this team to do well and be successful because it makes my job more fun and better. You guys deserve better than what has gone on with this franchise over the last couple of years.
On one hand, there's a portion of the fan base that's relieved it's not Josh McCown. If you were an ABM, anyone but McCown, you're feeling, all right, well, Lovie Smith's qualified. He's got experience. So you're feeling kind of relieved from that standpoint. But then if you think big picture, you really think the plan after they fired Bill O'Brien was going to be, let's hire a guy we never heard of, no one's ever heard of, and David Culley, fire him after 1 year, and then we come back with Lovie Smith getting an opportunity for the third time. My biggest issue with hiring Lovie Smith is not Lovie personally. It's just the process that led them to go to Lovie Smith. Like, if you were truly trying to have a wide open search and bring in the most qualified candidates, then you needed to speak to more than just six people, not including Lovie Smith. When two of your six candidates, before Lovie emerged as a panic move because they realized there'd be too much backlash to hire Josh McCown, you needed to speak to Byron Leftwich. You needed to speak to Jim Caldwell. You needed to speak to D'Amico Ryans. You needed to speak to Eric Bieniemy. If you wanted a minority coach with experience, there were guys out there. They didn't speak to any of those guys. So Lovie Smith just feels like a panic move. On one hand, I like Lovie. He did a pretty good job as the DC last year, and I think he's a solid, you know, like safe hire. But this team is not in position to get the benefit of the doubt right now. Not with the way they've handled this search. And it just feels like you're settling in a major way if you're a Texans fan, and you're really happy about Lovie Smith being this team's next head coach.
BK's been talking about it for the 2021 season. Felt like a Clint Black song, Killing Time.
Mm-hmm.
Convince me Lovie Smith's not killing time again, just on a longer timeline. I mean, that's what it feels like, really, with Lovie Smith. And, Jake, you talked about the process. Ultimately, it ended up including seven names. Of those seven names, four of them were not talked to by other teams. Lombardi was not talked to by another team. Hines Ward was not talked to by another team. Josh McCown was not talked to by another team. And ultimately, like BK said, Lovie Smith was not talked to by another team. They did not cast a wide enough net. And they did not cast a wide enough net because they knew what they wanted to do. And they did not do what they wanted to do as plan A because they got scared. And BK, you and I talked about it last week. That is not something that we deemed an acceptable move. If you're going to take the risk, if you're going to bet it all on Josh McCown, bet it all on Josh McCown and damn whoever is going to be critical of you. But instead, the headlines, the whispers, and perhaps the voices from outside the building had an intense effect on what the Texans ended up doing at the head coaching spot. And by the way, you can simultaneously have not wanted Josh McCown to be the head coach and be disappointed that they ended up with Lovie Smith.
Mm-hmm.
Those two things are not, like, you cannot, like, those two things are not
mutually
combative.
Exclusive.
Yeah, like, you can both, you can have both of those opinions as your opinion. You can be excited that it's not McCown and disappointed that it is Lovie Smith.
Yeah, we've all given our disapproval of Josh McCown over the past couple of weeks, but you could have done a whole hell of a lot better than Lovie Smith. It's not like your only two options were Josh McCown and Lovie Smith. I mean, there were other people out there, other strong candidates that you didn't even try to talk to, right? Not everybody would have accepted this job. Brian Daboll wouldn't have taken this job over the New York Giants. There are some coaching candidates out there that are happier in other spots, but there are plenty of qualified candidates, guys who are better options than either Josh McCown or Lovie Smith that would have loved to have taken this job, and the Texans didn't even talk to them.
BK, a year ago, and we've talked about this, about the type of job that the Houston Texans situation is and how bad it is and why would this guy come here and why would this guy talk to him. A year ago, they were in a worse situation. There was zero clarity with Deshaun Watson. There was no direction with the franchise. And 2021, before it even really got started, felt like a lost year. And they still talked to three of the top candidates on the market. A year ago, they talked to Eric Bieniemy, who was talked to by a bunch of different teams. They talked to Matt Eberflus, who was talked to by a couple of different teams and ultimately got hired in this hiring cycle, and they talked to Brandon Staley. So I don't want to hear that people would turn you down when a year ago, in a worse situation, you talked to three of the top candidates. You didn't even try to talk to some of the top candidates. And oh, by the way, why did they pivot immediately to Lovie Smith? Why didn't they just restart the coaching search? There's one other team that's going to hire. So if you talk to, I don't know, three different guys that are all new, the Saints could only hire one of them. And they're not even going to hire those guys because they're going to promote their DC. So why didn't you just restart the coaching search and go get someone that's exciting? Go get someone of note. And oh, by the way, if you're just trying to check a box, which it kind of feels like they are, you could have found a minority candidate. Hell, the first three guys I would have talked to probably would have been minority candidates.
I don't know how you could have any faith in Nick Caserio running this team going forward. Like, that's kind of where I'm at based on how this search has been done. His first draft was pretty good. He deserves credit for that. But there's been a lot of things that have now happened in year one that make you really shake your head. Like, Nick Caserio grinded for 20 years in the Patriots organization to hire David Culley and then promote from within with Lovie Smith as his two coaches. Like, I heard the Killer Bees talking about, will Caserio get an opportunity to hire a third coach? He shouldn't. If Lovie Smith stinks it up, the excuse can't be, well, I wasn't able to get my guy because, you know, the Flores lawsuit came out and that prevented me from hiring Josh McCown, who I wanted all along. Like, say that sentence out loud. I couldn't get my guy and my guy was Josh McCown, so now I need to get a third head coaching hire. Like, it doesn't work that way. Like, Caserio, in my opinion, has totally fumbled the bag here. And you're right, Cody. If you were just going to end up with Lovie Smith, okay, maybe you end up there, but why not open up the search once again and start interviewing more names? You're in zero rush. Caserio runs the show anyway, so it's not like you're in such a rush to get the coaching staff in place, you know, to get ready for the Senior Bowl. Newsflash, that already happened. It's not like you're in such a rush to get ready for the combine. Your scouts handle that. You got those people in place already. Like, open your search back up and hire someone qualified. Lovie Smith, you could say, is qualified, but then you're just settling if that's your feeling. Like, if you're relieved it's Lovie just because it's not McCown, the bar is way too low if you're a fan of the
low.
Texans. Like, you're an NFL franchise.
Oh, my God.
1-32. Bill O'Brien gets canned after 6 years. And if you would have told Texans fans then and there that your next two head coaches would be one guy no one's ever heard of and a guy in Lovie Smith who's a retread going on his third team. There's no way anyone with a brain would have signed up for that at the time when they fired B.O.B.
This is currently the worst-run franchise in professional American sports, fellas. It is. We're not just talking about the NFL anymore. We're talking about all four of the major American professional sports. Move over, Sacramento Kings. Congratulations. You guys aren't dead last anymore. The Houston Texans have surpassed you. My question is, I've got a million questions. One of my questions is, why not just keep David Coley? If you were going to hire another bridge guy, another de facto interim guy who's only going to be here for a year, two, maybe three, why not bring David Coley back for another season? Instead, you paid him $22 million to leave, and then you're hiring his defensive coordinator. What was the point of this? What was the point of this entire search? All of these interviews he did over the last couple of weeks. All of the search firms you've hired. What was the point of this? To settle on Lovie Smith. The bar should not be this low, Jake. You said it. The bar should not be low. You should not be accepting of this as a Texans fan, Cody, because there's no other fan base in pro sports that would be accepting of this.
I just don't know how your plan A is Josh McCown. It's as risky as it is. I mean, you went from the riskiest potential hire in this hiring cycle to the safest hire in this hiring cycle with the lowest probability of moving you forward at a rapid pace. Because we're watching a team on Sunday in the Super Bowl that moved forward at a rapid pace. BK's talked about it. Jake has talked about it. The NFL does not let you suck for a long time. You have to try and mess stuff up. And you have to try really hard to suck for a long time. And somehow this organization went from, we're going to do the riskiest thing possible to actually changed our mind. We're going to do the safest thing possible. And then they're going to sit behind a microphone at some point this week and tell us, no, this was something that we were considering doing all along. Poppycock. Poppycock. That's a lie.
Who?
Poppycock. It's a British way to say BS.
David Ortiz?
Okay.
Combined with...
British BS. Okay. Yeah, that's the best way I could describe it. Like, that's just not going to be something that I could accept as the truth from the Texans organization. And look, I understand that you may have succumbed to some outside pressure. You could have succumbed to some outside pressure and still had a knock it out of the park hire at the head coach spot, not an absolute total settle at the head coach spot, which is what Lovie Smith has become.
Yeah, the outside pressure could have been the wake-up call to restart the search and interview some more qualified candidates, not just go, oh, well, crap, what do we do? Let's go to Lovie Smith because we know he'll say yes. Come on.